Sam. We're out here for the opening of Mark's Place Pizza Joint in Carlton Corner, Swanston and Grattan. We're here, we're having a great time. Now, I'll just take you inside. We'll come in and have a look what's going on. We've got horns going off, got the people going off. Is it all right if we get in, guys? Okay, we'll come through. Follow us here. Now, here we are inside. We've got them all in here. You can see we've got them all going off tonight. We're having a great opening here. Now, we're just walking through. There's a few players. We've got Rupert. Come over here, mate. How's things, all right? Rupert Betheras from the Collingwood Football Club here. Now, Rupert, Anzac Day game this week. Is this your first one or you've played in one before?
Actually, played last year in the Anzac Day game and pretty excited about Tuesday's game.
Settle down.
At Collingwood, we've put a pretty big emphasis on the Anzac spirit. We actually, as a group, we went and watched the film Gallipoli today. Which was great because, a lot of the young blokes hadn't seen that film. So that was, really, really good experience for some of our boys.
It's a fantastic spirit. We've played in many Anzac Day games and I think this one's going to be one of the biggest. Thanks very much, Rupert. Right. Let's see. We've got Mark Mercuri here. We've got Mark Mercuri here. Now, Mercs, you've been missing. Now, what's going on? You're going to be playing this week? It's one of the biggest games of the year.
Yeah, well, I've had a bit of a sore bottom and hopefully...
That's good. Now, I was just talking to Merckx before. He said he's got a sore bottom. He's just getting the girls to rub it for him to make sure it's better. So you're definitely in?
I trained last night and everything went pretty well. And it's amazing, actually, you're giving out free drinks tonight, Seth, so all the boys will be shocked.
That's it. Free drinks to all the Collingwood guys, none of the Essendon guys. So there we go. Over. Got one of the old mates here. We got Barry Young. Barry, how's things?
Seth, going well.
Going well. Now listen, Hawthorn, travelling, getting there, not too bad at the moment. Won a couple of games. Now, how are you going personally down there?
Yeah, it's taken a little while to settle in, and we're not where we'd like to be. We're only 2-4, so this week's game is very important for the club, and we really need to win this one.
Now, Bulldogs, big game. We played against them last week. They're probably coming off a loss, so it's going to be pretty tough.
Yeah, both sides coming off a loss. As you know, we copped a pretty decent hiding over in Adelaide. So, we've got a lot of good players back this week and a lot of players keen to prove themselves. So we're looking forward to a very big game.
No worries. Thanks, Youngie. Now, you would not believe who makes the pizzas in this place. I'll just take you here. Come and have a look who's making the pizzas. We've got them working hard. Hopefully we're working them too hard. There we go. Boys, how are we travelling back there?
We're a bit hectic at the moment.
Now, get into it. Now, any questions from the guys on the panel you want to ask the guys in here?
Yeah, now Anthony or Sav, just to show it's fair dinkum, couldn't fling one of those bits of dough over your head like one of those plates, could you?
I'll leave that to Sav, actually, mate.
Come on, Sav.
I actually can't. I'll give it a go, but...
Righto, mate. She can have it. Here we go. Not bad. Very nicely done. Now, 95 thou might be there. Anthony, won't worry you too much, I suppose. But, Sav, you ever played in front of that number before?
Actually, in 94 we had, I think, about 94,000. So, hopefully this week coming we'll get about the same amount.
There we go.
Guys, it's Stephen, Anthony and Sav owning the shop. Why Marks?
Why Marks?
Yes.
Well, Mark is a good friend of ours. Anth, you can tell the story. Oh,
thanks, Steve. I guess Mark's got his own pizza shop in Coburg, so we thought we might just venture out with that as well. And so, that was the reason.
Sess, just a quick question, mate.
Yes.
Mark Mercuri's sore bottom, that wasn't caused in any way by the food at Mark's place, was it?
Mate, we haven't got dodgy vindaloos on the menu.
Fantastic, mate.
Now, Anthony, I must ask you...
Okay.
Footy Show, 20 larges.
20 larges for the Footy Show. Has there been an order put in by the Footy Show, has there?
Yep, big order. Sorry, it's on.
Sorry, it just looks as if the security guards have come in. Sorry, they've done a colonial. They've done a colonial on us here, Ed. So we'll have to throw it back to you, mate. We're getting thrown out here.
All right, boys, we'll leave you there at Mark's place. Put your hands together for the boys out there, the Rocca boys.
Ed, I was going to ask Anthony Rocca, in light of Justin Lepich,
just getting down from 5-2, would we be reappealing?
Mm.
Would we be reappealing, Ed?
No, we won't be, Sam.
Won't we?
Time's up.
Can't think of another excuse, but the light's getting in his eyes.
Well, we'll go back there. If we get the boys back to Anthony Rocca, I'll ask him in a second. Anthony, are there?
Yeah, I'm here, mate.
Anthony, Sam wants to know, would you like to appeal again?
I think at this stage, no, I wouldn't. But looking at Justin Lippich, it's a bit hectic at the moment here, boys, but.
You thought of some other reason beside the lights, maybe some other plausible reason, Anthony?
Actually, the one behind the camera is starting to get in my eyes a bit. I might deck someone over there.
Yeah, I've just got to be careful I don't get whacked here because the light's shining in both our eyes. Yeah,
well, actually, Anthony, while you're there, given the fact you're not playing, you can't just king hit a few of those Essendon blokes, can you, right now?
I think we might stick something in their food, I think, Eddie.
Yeah, we're no food tonight.
All right. Yeah, good luck with it.
Good on you, boys, and good luck at Mark's Place down there in Carlton. Let's have a look at the teams for the Anzac Day Bonanza game between Collingwood and Essendon. Let's go to the Maggies. And as you can see, three players coming into the Collingwood side. Jukovic, Brown, and for the first time, former Fitzroy player Simon Hawking has been named in the side. Also on Brisbane and Sydney's list for a while, and he's there obviously on the bench in case Simon Prestigiacomo doesn't come up after his ankle injury against North Melbourne last week. The Maggies had their first loss, 5 wins and 1 loss for the season, 3rd place on the ladder, but they're up against the team that everyone says is unbeatable. Barnard, Michael Long and Mark Mercuri coming into the side. No one out as yet, so there'll be a bit of room to be made for those players coming in possibly. And the Bombers just cruising along. The Bulldogs, a very good side, beaten by 10 goals last week. Gary Moorcroft plays his 50th game. As far as Anzac Day clashes are concerned, Collingwood have won 3-1. But Lordy, it's been a big build-up to this game at Windy Hill.
It has been. Apart from finals, you have to say the Anzac Day game is as close to it. And I think the last few years have been great games, and from our point of view, Dustin Fletcher, I think he's just been great and has really taken the next step as a player. Blake Carousella got dropped back to the seconds, and the last 2 weeks has been fantastic. And to Scotty Lucas, well done on a great comeback. But I think the Pies, a great young side, and will really give it to us this week. But will Prestigiacomo be playing? Because I know line up on him.
Presti, well, hopefully Presti will be tested. He has got an ankle injury, and Simon Hawking is there in the emergency, so that's the backup. But this is what they're playing for the first time. This is a magnificent trophy. It's worth $25,000, this trophy. It's solid silver on the top, and I tell you what, you'll need to get half a dozen players to go up and lift it. It's
very heavy.
12 kilos or something it is.
I can't see how heavy it
is. It's a glass pillar, images of the servicemen and the footballers etched, all the names of the AFL footballers who gave their lives in active service. The wooden fronting there on the front has actually got ironbark plank, part of an ammunition wagon from the First World War. The bronze columns incorporate metal salvage from the Gallipoli battlefield. So it's a magnificent trophy, as I said, worth over $25,000 just for it. But obviously the sentimental value now worth plenty. And Sam, you're opening up a new medal, which is going to be for the best player on the ground. It's going to be voted for by Ron Barassi. And Barass will decide which player is the best one on the ground. You'd like to have that one hanging around. Just
great.
A magnificent trophy, and just getting better and better. And just quickly, for the game is sold out, but for Collingwood season ticket holders, they can get in for standing room at the Southern Stand on Tuesday's game. The gates open at midday, but standing room only for that match, which is likely to be televised just the same. Who's going to win it, Glenn?
I think with the entire Essendon team playing the way they are as a unit, it'd be hard to back against them.
Yeah, it's just a big day for the Collingwood team to see how they perform, the young guys, after getting beaten last week. So it'll be interesting to see how they go, but very hard to tip against Essendon.
Sam, obviously, with Mel Michael out of the side.
Yes, and they saw Gallipoli, did they?
Yeah.
The side, yeah. Well, I think, Ed, I think Collingwood 6 goals, they'll get within 6 goals of Essendon.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe get with, if they're playing well, they'll get within 6 goals.
You think Anthony being out and maybe Presti and...
Mm. Oh, I don't care. They're going to have. It doesn't matter who's out or who's in it. They'll get beaten by at least 6 goals.
Yeah, well, we'll
but
see.
But because everyone will.
It's going to be a great day. In fact, there's going to be 3 banners on the day, one for Essendon and one for Collingwood. And then after the boys line up, they're going to run through a banner together to symbolise that all Australians together on the MCG.
And Sheila from New York's got no idea what you're talking about. She
has
no idea.
Will that be at the same time, Ed?
What's that?
Running through the banner at the same time.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll see how it goes. might be a bit of an Anzac Day right from the very start, but it's going to be a great day, and also paying tribute to the Aboriginals who served in the war. But just before we go, this is a fantastic thing. It's a little horseshoe, as you can see. Just get a quick shot of it there, and then I'll turn it around and read it. Now, this came from a Collingwood player by the name of Malcolm Doc Seddon. In 1917, it says, good luck on it, and it says, to the Collingwood Football Club France from Doc, and it just reads, the shoe was made from a driving band of a German 15-inch shell which Seddon found. The nails were made from pieces of a German aeroplane which the Australians brought down over the Somme. And he sent it, he got the blacksmith in the AIF on the right at the front to make that into a good luck horseshoe and send it to the Collingwood team, and they went on and won the 1917 premiership with it. And in fact, the Doc, who was gassed at the front, came back and played in the 1919 premiership side. So just some of the great efforts that have happened in AFL football. It's just fantastic.
Now, if that was supposed to be a good luck horseshoe, Ed, wouldn't that be up the other way?
It is, yeah, that's exactly right. Edna Richards rang up, Lou Richards' wife, and said, make sure you hold it up the right way, because if you hold it down, all the good luck drains out of it, apparently. And it's going to be like that from now on.
Only Collingwood players in the war were there,
Ed? No, but... No.
other players...
Had there been a few more Collingwood players, it wouldn't have gone as long, I can tell you.
Trent, I was going to say, if we had a choice.
no, Sam, I can tell you that certainly all clubs paid the price during all the wars, particularly the First and Second World Wars. And we pay tribute tonight to some of the great men of football who returned, and also remember those who didn't, to make the Australian game one of the great games in a democracy. Let's have a look at our tribute to the veterans.
I'm Ron Baggett, and I played 133 games for Melbourne.
I played, in all, 55 games with Collingwood.
My name's Jack Jones, and I played for Essendon from 1946 to 1954.
I'm Fred Flanagan. I played with Geelong from 1946 to 1955.
The 39-40-41 side, I honestly believe, would have gone on had it not been for the war and won perhaps at least another three on end.
Of the 39 players they had, only about five were permanents. The rest of them were committed for the war eras.
Born and bred in Ascot Vale, and I was a keen Essendon supporter, and when I went away to the war, well, I used to listen on the radio when we could get a chance to see how they were going.
I joined up at when I was 17 years and 11 months, I think it was. I know I hadn't turned 18. And I was posted to the 2nd Australian Field Regiment.
Well, I would say that apart from the fact that I missed 2.5 years of football, the war had no effect on my career at all.
I unfortunately copped a piece of shrapnel that, fortunately, it hit my belt, and that took the power off it, but even then it cut the belt in the front, the brass buckle, and skidded into inside my stomach a little way. But it was, I'll never forget the time it was, I managed even to try and pick it out, and it was red hot, it seemed to be.
In our battalion, lost quite a few men, you know, about 110, I think, and about 180 wounded, so, you know, we were in the thick of it, yeah.
So we were out on this patrol, and this mortar bomb came over and killed a couple of the infantiers, and I got the blast. And I was airborne, I'm certain of that, and I was stunned. And they couldn't get me out at that particular stage because of what was happening around us.
I was listening to the 1945 grand final in Bougainville, and never dreaming that I'd be in the next year's grand final, so it was a great thrill.
I used to communicate with Ron Todd a lot, and he used to write to me, and he'd say, one day you're fighting is one day near the end of the war, he used to say.
Both teams, Essendon and Melbourne, lined up for a couple of minutes silence prior to the game to pay tribute to the late Ron Barassi, and he was a good mate of Norm Smith and myself, and I can tell you now that tears did roll down both Norm Smith's face and mine before the ball was bounced for the 1941 Grand Final.
And of course, the fellows would talk about the funny things that happened. They'd never talk about the serious things, people being killed and that was never mentioned.
The mates and that were left behind up there, they were, you know, you got to know them pretty well because you were sleeping with them and fighting with them, and, you know, when they went and they were left still up there now, well, it was very hard, you know. And on Anzac Day is a bit of a solemn occasion, you know, because you think of not yourself, but you think of them and their parents and their brothers and sisters and next of kin, you know. Must be terrible for them on Anzac Day.